This is a wonderful example of how prior knowledge is required to understand new learning. So let's say for sake of conversation, you didn't know that this was a chocolate company. And I'm only saying for sake of conversation because I sure as hell didn't know until I had to look this stuff up. So this is a great example of you come into an ad, you immediately understand what it's doing. Didn't we look at the Cadbury Gorilla a couple weeks ago? Yeah,
we did. Yeah.
So we have a classic ad from a classic chocolate company that these guys are going to take the piss out of and play with. Problem is, I didn't know they were a chocolate company until after the fact. So I guess on one hand, this is really good in that it forced me to do some thinking. It forced me as a human being to go to say, hey, I recognize something. I don't quite have all the pieces. Let me go piece it together myself. And a good rule of thumb, anytime a human being has to work, the memory, the learning, the understanding gets deeper. The fact that I actually had to go look up their website and figure out what it was they sold, congratulations, that means I'm probably never going to forget. But it's a good thing to remember that there's going to be a lot of people out there who won't know that they're a chocolate company. We'll see this ad and we'll immediately just think, Cadbury, they're taking the piss. Forget you. That was a great ad. You're screwing with my Cadbury ad. I'm out of here.
But yeah, I agree. Like, you have got to have had exposure to Cadbury to understand the piss take that this was. You've also got to understand why palm oil is so bad as well. You require that prior learning, you know? So for me, nearly takes us back to when we were talking about the moldy burger. Laying the groundwork. So if you set it up like you were discussing with Moldy Burger, where you've got to go, palm oil is in everything from chocolate to makeup, shampoo to ice cream. You can't often see it in the ingredients list because it's hidden as vegetable oil. You know, demand is increased by 400% since 1995. You position this as like the antichrist or the worst thing that's going on. Then you've got more leverage. So I felt that potentially you could have really plowed the soil to have a very fertile runway for the mass market. Yeah. But on the flip side, if you're very aware of palm oil, you know the problems with palm oil, that talks directly to you. So you've owned a segment of the market, and that segment may be consuming Cadbury, and they'll be second guessing going, ooh, maybe I don't want to be supporting a brand that goes against my beliefs.
Let's say they're going for the healthy market. You've already picked your audience. There's not everyone in the world is health conscious. Not everyone's going to go get the sugar-free chocolate. Why? Because it tastes nasty most of the time. So there's going to be a good 60% of the people who don't care, in which case I think they're pretty good by saying, you know what, I don't care about you. We're going to go for this group here. With that said, I don't know jack about palm oil, but it was clear that what they were going for was a more holistic, more environmental, healthier version of that ad. So you've got a big, heavy gorilla in a human environment versus a really light, healthy looking orangutan in the jungle where it's green and it looks like he's in his natural environment and he's just having a good old time. So I think even without the deep knowledge, I was able to piece the idea that they're saying we're somehow environmentally conscious. And they got that through just by the setting, just by the scenery. I don't know why.
See, this is where I go, like, you've anyone that is aware of it, and I'm not sure how big this segment it is, but it's probably 5 to 15% that are very, very hyper aware of how bad palm oil is for the environment. And the reason it's so bad is that, you know, Malaysia, Indonesia are two of the largest countries that export palm oil. Palm oil is a great vegetable oil because you can produce it en masse. But the challenge is both of those countries are literally setting forests on fire to clear the way, killing orangutans, tigers, you name it, endangered species all throughout in the quest of clearing land for more palm oil.
So you're right. You got to set that up. What a missed opportunity to paint the bad guy. Very rarely is it kosher to have a very clear bad guy in an ad. You're talking about a secondary thing. So there's no libel here. You're not making fun of. It's a very easy antagonist that you can now bring your protagonist in with. And you're right. I'm sad that they miss that.
And that's what I mean. I think they got a little bit swept away with the piss take of Cadbury rather than the really hammering home the message.
There has to be an element of education in anything that is fringe, in anything that's trying to change the mold. That's how you change the mold, is you can't change it by just continuing to play in the rules and say, ooh, that sucks. You have to teach people why it sucks, give them the foundation, and then they'll follow you out.
If there's a pain point or something that elicits emotion that makes someone feel uncomfortable, and I'm looking to sell a particular that's a better solution, I like to push that, you know, and really get in there and push the pain point just before the solution comes. So pain, pleasure, problem, solution.
That pain point is a what your brain registers as an error. It's a disconnect between reality and your version of reality in your head. And that's the pain is your brain essentially saying, change. You'll literally never learn better, faster, or easier than right after you feel that pain, because biologically the system, that's that feeling. The system is saying we have to update our story, our understanding immediately. So that's why if you then pull in that pleasure, congratulations, everything is primed to update, take that new message in, and ideally play with it.